Moving now to a major project that will affect millions of travelers across Northern California. We are just hours away from a five-day closure of the Bay Bridge.
And it's going to impact more than just the daily commuters. We could actually see a ripple effect across the freeways and the surrounding Bay Area bridges.
KCRA's Brian Hickey joins us now live in West Sacramento with more on how this will impact super commuters from the Sacramento area.
Yeah, we've got a pretty diehard group of super commuters that head out of this parking right here in West Sacramento every morning. And we talked to them this morning about how they're going to deal with the Bay Bridge shutdown that starts tonight at 8 p.m. And this morning, a lot of them told us they're going to get a little bit earlier start, some avoiding it altogether. But they say this is a necessary evil as they put that new east span of the bridge in action there in the Bay Area. As they get ready to connect it to the toll plaza at the Oakland touchdown, and then also connecting it to Yerba Buena Island, they say they need to shut down the bridge to take care of that work, also do some new barriers, do the striping on the roads, the things they need to do to get that new east span in service across the bay. Now, in order to do that, they're also going to work on the western span of the bridge as well, doing some general maintenance on the bridge. They've done this in 2006, 2007, and 2009. They say it's a historically light traffic period, and they say it's a good time to do it. Drivers this morning saying, you know what, they're just going to have to deal with it, good or bad.
I think it'll work out okay.
Yeah.
I think they have a plan in place, and I think if people are really smart, they will find another means of transportation or they won't go.
Nah, we'll probably go at the same time. The morning's not so bad. Oh. It's just I think it's more of the afternoon commute that's right. gonna really hurt. So maybe we can get off early.
And we're just go on vacation. There's a lot of drivers that obviously are going to be looking for other bridges. There's here from this park and ride, there's a big group that goes to San Quentin, several vans, part of a van pool. They realize that this will impact them because they will now be sharing their bridge with others as the San Mateo Bridge, a big alternative that a lot of people sound like they're going to be taking along with the Dumbarton Bridge as well. So give yourself some extra time. We've heard everything from 15 minutes to an hour. And they say just have to get through it. But again, they're saying this is a historically light traffic time, and it's the best time if you have to do it. Live here in West Sacramento, I'm Brian Hickey, KCRA 3 News.